Welcome to Simple Stress and Strain, Strength of Materials. In this video, we will be going to see the numericals related to the bulk modulus, modulus of rigidity and modulus of elasticity. So numerical number one, a bar of 20 mm diameter is tested in tension. It is observed that when a load of 37.7 kN is applied, the extension measured over a gauge length of 200 mm is 0.12 mm and contraction in diameter is 0.036 mm. Find the Poisson's ratio and elastic constants E, G and K. So this is the first numerical question. Writing the given data. So given data is like this. Diameter 20 mm, load is 37.7 into 10 raised to 3 newtons. Gauge length L 200 mm, area pi by 4 20 square, so 314.16 mm square, extension delta 0.12 mm and contraction in diameter is 0.0036 mm. So once the length is increased, so the lateral dimension gets decreased, so that decrease we have taken it as the contraction. So finding that particular values, linear strain we will find first. That is the change in the length divided by original length 0.0006. Then lateral strain, change in diameter upon original diameter, it comes as 0.00018. Poisson's ratio is the direct value of lateral strain to longitudinal strain. So sometimes longitudinal strain is also known as linear strain. Substituting the values into the formula and calculating the value of mu, 0.3 as Poisson's ratio. Delta is the change in the length. So already known, the change in length is 0.12 mm. So P is known to us, length is known to us, area is known to us. Unknown value is capital E, that is modulus of elasticity or Young's modulus capital E. Calculating the, substituting the values and rearranging to calculate the value of E. So E comes out to be 200004.24 Nm². The same problem when we consider for the further part. We have the relation of E is equals to 2 into G into bracket 1 plus mu. We get G as rearranging the formula E divided by 2 into bracket 1 plus mu. So substituting the values, we get the value of G as 76924.88 Nm². Then the particular value of K. So E is equals to, we have one more relation. E is equals to 3k into 1 minus 2 times mu. Finding the k as E divided by 3 times into bracket 1 minus 2 times mu. 166670.2 Nm² is the value. K value. Then comes the particular second question. A circular rod of 100 mm dia and 500 mm long is subjected to a tensile force of 1000 kN. Determine modulus of rigidity, bulk modulus and change in volume. If Poisson's ratio is 0.3 and Young's modulus capital E is equals to 2 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm². Now the given data for this question is diameter 100 mm, load is 1000 kN, 1000 into 10 raised to 3 newtons, length L as 500 mm, area pi by 4 into 100 square the value, Poisson's ratio mu is equals to 0.3, Young's modulus E is equals to 2 into 10 raised to 5 newton per mm². Then the value comes as, we have the relationship E is equals to 2G into bracket 1 plus mu, G value is known to us, 76923 into 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm². Similarly, K value we are going to calculate with the equation K is equals to E divided by 3 into minus 1 minus 2 times mu, substituting the value and calculating 166.67 into 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm square. Now, we know longitudinal stress. When we are trying to pull, the stress is acting along the length. That is called as longitudinal stress. P by A, load upon area, calculating the stress as 127.2323 Newton per mm square. The particular linear strain is stress upon Young's modulus. How it is stress upon Young's modulus means the capital E is equals to the stress divided by strain. We know already this part of formula. So using this formula, strain is equals to stress upon E, Young's modulus, calculating the strain 63.662 into 10 raised to 5. Lateral strain. So here the lateral strain will be contraction, change in the dimension. So that is under EY and Z direction. So length extension is in X direction, change in Y direction, change is in Z direction. So what is the change? Reduction in the area or the volume. The reduction in lateral dimension, minus mu sigma x upon ex, that is ex, small ex, it is ex is equals to strain in x direction is equals to stress in x direction divided by Young's modulus in x direction. Substituting this part here in this mu and multiplication, then calculating volumetric strain, E volume, EV is equals to EX, strain in X direction, strain in Y direction, strain in Z direction. So strain in X direction is EX itself, then strain in Y direction is minus mu sigma X by EX, strain in Z direction is minus mu into sigma X by EX. So calculating all the values, so here we are substituting in this particular formula as E into X plus, that is minus of mu into EX, then plus minus of mu into EX. So EX is equals to into bracket 1 minus 2 times mu. Now substituting the values which are known to us. So this is EX, linear strain is already EX what we have calculated. Substituting the value of mu and EX, we get volumetric strain as 25.465 into 10 raised to minus 5, dimensionless. It is volumetric strain. We have change, that is volumetric strain is equals to change in volume upon original volume. Hence, therefore, change in volume is equals to volumetric strain multiplied by original volume. Substituting the values, change in the volumetric strain multiplied by area length into the diameter square, we get the volume, original volume. The change in the volume is dv is equals to 1000 mm raised to cube is the change in volume. Thank you. See you in the next video.